Hello students, once again welcome back to our science class. As you know, in the previous session we have discussed about call and its important uses. Today in this session we are going to discuss about the products of call, that is the various products obtained by heating call in the absence of air are call gas, call tar and coke. These three are called products of coal. That is, these three are obtained by heating coal in the absence of air. We will discuss about these three one by one in detail. First one is coal gas. From the name itself, we can say it is a gaseous fuel. And it is obtained during the processing of coal to get coke. And coal is a mixture of several gases like methane, hydrogen and some carbon monoxide. That is a lot of gases together to form coal gas. Coal gas is a gaseous fuel and it is obtained during the processing of coal to get coke, and it is a mixture of several gases like methane, hydrogen and some carbon monoxide. And coal gas is mostly used as a source of heat rather than light, because when coal gas is heated, a good amount of light and a good amount of heat are produced. In earlier days, coal gas is used for street lighting. But nowadays, coal gas is mostly used as a source of heat, and hence coal gas is an excellent fuel and which is used as fuel in industries. That is, in the earlier stages, coal gas is used as a source of light. That's why they are used for street lighting. But nowadays, coal gas is considered, or coal gas is mostly used as a source of heat, and hence coal gas is an excellent fuel and which is used as fuel in industries. Okay, second one is the coal tar. Coal tar is a black color thick liquid. The figure is given in your textbooks and you can see it is a liquid which is not so loose or soft. It is thick and which is black in color. And it is having an unpleasant smell. That is, it is having a bad smell. And which is also obtained by heating coal in the absence of air. Just like coal gas, coal tar is also obtained by heating coal in the absence of air. And this coal tar is not a single compound. It is a mixture of about 200 carbon compounds like benzene, toluene, naphthalene, etc. I think all of you are familiar with the naphthalene balls in your home. It is used to resist or used to repel moths and other insects, isn't it? And these naphthalene balls are obtained from coal tar. The naphthalene balls which are used in our home are obtained from coal tar. That is, various compounds which are present in the coal tar are separated by the process of fractional distillation. This is a fractional distillation, is a separation technique which is used to separate various compounds from coal tar. Once again, coal tar is a black color thick liquid and which is having a bad smell and which is also obtained by heating coal in the absence of air. And this coal tar is not a single compound. It is a mixture of about 200 carbon compounds like phenol, benzene, toluene, naphthalene, anthracene, etc. And these naphthalene balls are familiar with you. And it is used to resist or repel moths and other insects, which is also obtained from coal tar. That is, various products are obtained salt are by the process of fractional distillation. The various products that are present or the various compounds that are present in the coulter is separated by the separational technique called fractional distillation. Fractional distillation is a separation technique and it is used to separate various compounds from coulter. Next one is, what are the uses of coulter? Coulter is used as a starting material for the manufacture of a lot of products like synthetic fiber, plastics, paints, varnishes, medicines, etc. etc. And in the earlier stages, coulter is used for metalling the raw surface. But nowadays, it is replaced by a petroleum product called bitumen. In the earlier days, coulter is used for metalling the road surface, but nowadays it is replaced by a petroleum product called bitumen. Okay, that's about coulter. And the last one is cork. Cork is a tough, porous, black solid. The figure is given in your textbooks and you can see that it is a black solid substance which is black in color and which is not a soft material, which is tough and it is porous, that is it contains small holes. Cork is a solid substance and which is black in color and which is tough and contains small holes. And cork is also obtained by heating coal in the absence of air. We know that coal gas and coal tar are obtained by heating coal in the absence of air. When coal is heated, coal gas and coal tar are eliminated and the remaining blank residue is cork. Therefore, it is considered as a pure form of carbon and this cork contains 98% of carbon, which is a big percentage. Therefore, coke is considered as a pure form of carbon. Once again, coke is a tough, porous, black solid and which is obtained by heating coal in the absence of air. We know that coal gas and coal tar are also obtained by heating coal in the absence of air. So, when a coal is heated, what will happen? Coal tar and coal gas are eliminated and the remaining black residue is the cork, and which contains 98% carbon. Therefore, cork is considered as a pure form of carbon. Next one is, what are the uses of cork? Cork is used as a reducing agent in the extraction of certain metals like zinc, iron, etc. So, coke is used as a reducing agent and it is also used in the manufacturing of steel and it is associated with an advantage when compared with coal. And there is an advantage which is associated with coke when it is compared to coal. What is that? Coke is a better fuel than coal. Coke is a better fuel than coal. Why coke is considered as a better fuel when compared to that of coal? Because coke produces heat when coke is burnt without producing smoke. It produces a lot of heat without producing any smoke. Whereas coal produces a lot of smoke when it is heated. Therefore, coal is a better fuel. Why coke is considered as a better fuel? When coke is burnt, it will produce a lot of heat without any smoke. Whereas coal on heating produces a lot of smoke. That's why coke is considered as a better fuel than coal. Okay, so this is for today's class and I hope all the concepts are clear to you. And in the next video, we will discuss about petroleum and natural gases. So, till then, do revise and go through each and every concepts and keep learning. Thank you.